Hi there and welcome to the IT Taster channel. I'm John and in this video I'm going to show you how to install and configure Active Directory Domain Services with Microsoft Windows Server 2016. Now Active Directory is a technology that enables us to build a Microsoft network that is scalable. It centralizes management and administration, dealing with things like user logins and permissions, as well as other essential network services. The server I'm going to be working with is a test server in the lab with Windows Server 2016 installed. The server is not part of a Microsoft Windows domain. It's currently a standalone server. However, I'm going to install Active Directory Domain Services to configure the server as a domain controller. But before installing Active Directory, we need to make sure the server is configured with a suitable host name and a static IP address to avoid issues later on. And we can do this within Server Manager. We need to click Local Server, click the computer name, click Change, and assign your server a suitable host name. I've given my server the host name of Server 1, and click OK. Now bear in mind when you do this, the server will need to reboot. Now as I've already assigned my server a host name, I can just cancel out of this. The next thing to do is to assign the server an IP address. Now after installing Windows Server 2016 for the very first time, the Ethernet adapter will be configured to obtain an IP address from DHCP. And DHCP will normally be shown here. So click DHCP, right click your Ethernet adapter, choose properties, choose IP version 4 and click properties. And you need to choose use the following IP address to assign a static IP address to the server. The IP address I've used is 192.168.0.110. I've configured a default class C subnet mask of 255.255.255.0. The default gateway I've assigned of 192.168.0.1 is my router. And for my preferred DNS server, I've configured it with the IP address of 127.0.0.1. Now this address is known as a loopback address, which means this host, this server, which is important when Active Directory integrated DNS is installed. So I can click OK and close this down. We're now ready to begin installing Active Directory Domain Services. So we need to click Manage, click Add Roles and Features. Now this screen tells us what the wizard does. And it also reminds us of some important tasks to carry out, including assigning our server a static IP address. And when you're ready, click Next. We need to select our installation type. I'm going to stick with a role-based or feature-based installation and click Next. Select the server to install the role on. Now, Server Manager allows us to manage multiple servers, and they will normally be shown here. I only have the one server, Server 1, which is already selected. So I just need to click Next. I need to select the role or roles I want to install on the server, which is Active Directory Domain Services. And I'm prompted to add features that are required by Active Directory Domain Services. So click Add Features. And notice in the upper right hand corner, we can see the server that we're installing the role on, Server 1. And this is useful to check when working with multiple servers. And click Next. On the Select Features screen, we can see that Group Policy Management has been selected automatically. Click Next. This screen gives a good overview of what Active Directory Domain Services does and mentions two important things to note. A minimum of two domain controllers are recommended for resilience, which is good practice because should a domain controller fail and go offline, the other domain controller will continue to service the network, dealing with things like user logins and other essential network services. It's also worth mentioning that having additional domain controllers helps to distribute the load placed on domain controllers, which is extremely important, especially in large enterprise networks. We're also informed that Active Directory Domain Services requires a DNS server to be installed on the network, and if we don't have one, we'll be prompted to install this role. It's important to clarify that this is referring to a Microsoft Dynamic DNS server, not an Internet DNS server. And there are also some useful links about Azure Active Directory and Office 365 connectivity, which are well worth taking the time to read through. And when you're done, click Next. On the Confirm Installation Selection screen, I'm going to tick Restart the Destination Server automatically if required, and click Yes to confirm. Now, I also have the option to export my configuration settings to an XML file. This allows us to automate this part of the installation should it need to be repeated on multiple servers. And when you're ready, click Install. At this stage, Windows is installing the installation binaries, and we're reminded that additional steps are required to make the server a domain controller. Now, with legacy versions of Windows Server, a command called dcpromo was used to make a server a domain controller. But with Windows Server 2012 and Windows Server 2016, this is done using Server Manager. Okay, the Active Directory Domain Services binary installation is now complete. And I'm reminded that additional steps are required to make this machine a domain controller. So I now need to click Promote this server to a domain controller. This brings me to the deployment configuration screen. I'm going to create a brand new installation of Active Directory, so I need to create a new forest and a new forest root domain. If you're not too familiar with Active Directory, forests and domains, take a look at my Active Directory overview video on the IT Taster channel. I'm going to choose Add a new forest. And I need to specify the forest root domain name, which must be in the form of a fully qualified domain name. Now, there are some important considerations to be aware of when specifying the name for a forest root domain. In the past, internal domain names were very common, names ending in .local or .internal. For example, ittaster.local. But this is best avoided in production environments. Instead, it's suggested that a subdomain of your public owned domain name is used. For example, training.ittaster.com. ittaster.com is my public owned domain name. But as this is a test server in the lab and not a production environment, I'm going to pretend that I don't have a public domain name and use an internal domain name. And I'm going to use ittaster.local. Now, if you want to learn more about Active Directory domain naming, take a look at my video, Active Directory DNS Domain Naming Considerations, which can be found on the IT Taster channel. And click Next. I now need to select Forest and Domain Functional Levels. Functional levels determine domain controller capabilities and, importantly, the supported operating systems the domain controllers can run. However, functional levels do not determine the operating systems of servers that are not domain controllers. Now, the forest functional level applies to all domains and all domain controllers in the forest, and is the minimum functional level. The domain functional level applies to all domain controllers within the domain. It cannot be set lower than the forest functional level, but it can be set higher. Forest and domain functional levels should be set as high as possible, and they can be raised later, but make sure all of your domain controllers are supported before raising functional levels. So do your homework first, it's really important. I'm not going to be working with any legacy operating systems, so I'm going to leave functional levels set at Windows Server 2016. Now, DNS has already been selected for me, and Microsoft Dynamic DNS Server is needed for Active Directory. And the Global Catalog Server option is also ticked but greyed out, because we must have at least one Global Catalog Server. The read-only domain controller option is unchecked and greyed out because the first domain controller cannot be a read-only domain controller. And finally, I need to specify an Active Directory restore mode password. This is very important should we need to perform an Active Directory recovery. And click Next. Under DNS options, I have a warning that tells me a delegation for this DNS server cannot be created. This is because DNS hasn't been installed yet, so I simply need to click Next. The NetBIOS domain name needs to be verified. Now I have the option to change the NetBIOS domain name here if I wish. Now NetBIOS domain names are a pre-Windows 2000 technology that has remained in use and can still be required by some applications and network devices. I'm going to leave my NetBIOS domain name as IT Taster and click Next. This screen gives me the option to specify the location of the Active Directory database, log files and sysvol folder. I'm going to stick with the defaults and click Next. On the Review Options screen, I'm able to review the selections I've specified. And also, these settings can be exported to a PowerShell script to automate additional installations. The wizard is now performing a prerequisite check. Prerequisites must be checked and validated before Active Directory domain services can be installed, which can take a few moments. The prerequisites check is complete, and we can see that all prerequisite checks have passed successfully, and we can click Install to begin the installation. Now notice in the View Results box we have a few warnings. This is to be expected when installing a brand new Active Directory forest. So we're now ready to click Install. Active Directory is now being installed, and at the end of the installation the server will reboot. Now the installation is going to take a little while, so I'm going to leave the install running and return to the video when the installation has completed. The installation is now complete. The server has rebooted and I now need to log in. Now notice that I'm no longer logging in as the local server administrator. I'm now presented with a domain login for the IT Taster domain, ittaster/administrator. I've logged back into the server and I'm back in Server Manager. and we can see the Server Manager dashboard is displaying two new roles. We now have an Active Directory Domain Services tile and also a DNS tile. And if we click on Local Server, we can now see our server, Server 1, belongs to the ittaster.local domain. And if we click on Tools, we have a number of Active Directory Management tools and also DNS. Active Directory has been successfully installed and the server is now a domain controller. Well, that brings us to the end of the video. I hope you found it helpful. Please give the video a like if you did, or leave a comment below. And don't forget, please subscribe to the IT Taster channel if you haven't already. Thanks very much for watching, and I'll see you next time.